Praise the Lord. It's another Monday. We are meeting together and the Lord has been good. And I want us to share the word that will give us a direction even as we pray on this Thursday. And I am praying that the Lord will give you understanding, that you will hold that which he has for you. And even as we prepare with the word for Monday, we normally prepare for it so that you can study. By the time you're meeting in Thursday, your heart is prepared for what God has for you and that you can receive even from the Lord. And I also read as I pray, that I'll pray the same for you, that you will receive of God. And I want you not to take our meetings for granted. I want you not to take the sermons that we read as just good words to encourage you for the day to go by. And I want you to be taking that they are the words that the Lord wants you to hear at that time and to do something about them. And I want to pray so that we can read the scripture. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we come before your throne. We want to thank you for another day that you've given us, Lord, that even as we study your word, dear Jehovah, this word is going to work in our lives, O God. This word is going to work in our situations, Lord. This word is going to change us, dear Redeemer, that we can be changed by your word, dear Lord. And the Bible says the entrance of your word brings light. And if this word enters into the heart of everyone that is listening to me, let it bring light. Let it bring life in the name of Jesus Christ. And even as that river that fell from the book of Ezekiel, that was going forth, Lord, touching lives, Lord, and bringing life, dear Lord, let this word, O God, carry that power in the name of Jesus Christ, that wherever I shall go, there shall be life. In Jesus' name I pray. For those who have joined me, you're welcome, as you continue to share the word of God. And even as I was praying, I remembered the word of the book of Ezekiel, that there was water that was flowing in the temple. And the Bible says it was an ankle level. And as he continued to see, Ezekiel saw the water level rise to the knee. The water rose to the waistline and again to overflow. And the Bible says as it flew from the temple, it went and brought life. And I want to pray for you, even as you hear this word, that it shall bring life to you in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says the word of God is living, active, sharper than a double-edged sword. That means it has life in it. And I pray that the life of this word will get to your life today in the name of Jesus Christ. We are talking about the mark of distinction, and I'm reading Daniel 1 from verse 3. And the Bible says, then the king ordered Ashpenaz, chief of his court officials, to bring in some of the Israelites from the royal family and the nobility, young men without any physical defect, handsome, showing aptitude for every kind of learning, well-informed, quick to understand, and qualified to serve in the king's palace. So I'm reading Daniel chapter 1, and I'm starting from verse 3. So this was a time the Israelites had gone to Babylon. They had been taken captive. The Lord had released them to the hands of the king of Babylon. And the Bible says the king ordered that men be brought to him. They are young men without physical defect, young men that are handsome, showing aptitude for every kind of learning, well-informed, quick to understand, and qualified to serve in king's palace. So I want you to understand and to know who we are talking about. We want to talk about Daniel, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. And the Bible is saying that the king ordered that men from the royal family. So Daniel was just not a nobody. He was not a small person. Daddy, karibu sana, karibu sana. You're welcome, you're welcome. Nice to see you and to hear from you. And the Bible says that there were people who were perfect. They did not have any defect. They were handsome. they were showing aptitude for every learning. So they were bright. Their minds were bright. And, you know, they were not just nobodies. They were not people from the street. They were people that were learned. Karonik, nice to see you. Long time. And the Bible says that the king ordered those people who are quick to understand, who are qualified to serve in the king's palace, be brought to serve in the king's palace. Lea Kamau, good to see you. And the Bible says he was to teach them the language and literature of Babylonians. The king assigned them a daily amount of food and wine from the king's table. They were to be trained for 3 years, and after that they were to enter the king's service. So these are people that are noble. These are people of understanding. These are people of character. They are people that are handsome. They are people that are good to look at. And yet the king is saying, they be taught the language of the Babylonians. And you know, they already had the teaching they had from where they came from. And the king wanted to teach them the attitudes and the things of that place. And I want to thank God for these young men. They had God with themselves, with all those good things that were in their head, in their hands, in their heads, in their body. You know, being handsome, no defect. Upright, you know, they were upright, they were not bent, they did not have defects, they did not have issues. They were being taught about the things of Babylon, and I want us to be careful by the things we are being taught. What are you taking in? Are you learning from Babylon, or you're holding on to the principles of God? When the king got them, he got them well able. He got them functioning right. Yet he wanted to inculcate them with the styles of the Babylonians. And I want you to be careful with the styles that are being inculcated into you. I want you to be a wise person, to choose your God first, to learn the things that do not conflict with the attitude and the standard of your God. You know, the king had them to be trained for 3 years, 3.5 years. And the Bible says they were to be trained 3 years. And after that, they were to enter the king's services. So they are already up and learned. They are qualified. They are learned. They are aptitude. But they were to be trained about Babylon. And I pray for God for you. Whatever place you are in, as they bring the teaching they are bringing, I want you to benchmark them with your word, the word of God. I want you to benchmark them with the principles you have been taught, that you will not leave the principles of God, that you will not leave the things of God, in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible says among them there was Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. So Daniel was given another name. The Bible says he was called Belshazzar. Hananiah was called Shadrach. Mishael was called Meshach. And Azariah was called Abednego. So the king was decoding them to what he can understand. And this is a conflict that we always find every time that we go to a new place. People want to classify us to what they can understand. And I don't know why the name Daniel continued sticking when the rest left their names and they carried the names they were given. And I pray when as people give you your name, you not lose your identity in God. As people are trying to give you a name so that they can understand you, I pray that God will make you to stand in the position he placed you, and with the name he gave you, do not agree to carry a name that is not of God, that is not from God. Those people that are giving you names, they want to bring you to their level. They want to bring you under whatever they think is right. But may you continue holding the name that God gives you. He calls you a victor. He calls you his child. He calls you a winner. Do not lose your identity because of the place you find yourself in. Do not lose your identity because of the trainings that you've gone through, that the world has put you to go through. Retain your name. Retain your identity in Christ Jesus. And the Bible says, but they were to be fed with fine. The Bible says, the king assigned them a daily amount of food and wine from the king's table. They were given food from the table of the king. And there was wine, there was the choice food. And verse 8 says, but Daniel resolved not to defile himself with the royal food and wine. And he asked the chief official for permission not to defile himself this way. So Daniel decided, I am here for this time, and there is nothing I can do about it. But there is one thing that I'm going to do. I will not conform. And the Bible says, do not be conformed to the patterns of this world. This world wants us to conform so that they can understand us. And immediately we conform, we lose our identity in God. And Daniel decided he is not going to feed from the place of the king, from the loyal food. He's going to continue with what he knows. I do not know which food that you need to stop eating from the table of the world, from the table of the enemy, from the table of those that do not know God. And I pray for wisdom that will come upon you, that you make that decision that Daniel made. And the Bible says they were being given choice food, and they did not eat the choice food. The Bible, let us continue reading. But the Bible says, now God had caused the official to show favor and sympathy to Daniel. But the official told Daniel, I'm afraid, my lord the king, who assigned your food and drink, why should he see you looking worse than other men your age? Then the king would have my head because of you. So Daniel had already found favor with this man because of God. And he was telling Daniel, I cannot stop giving you the choice food. I cannot stop giving you what the king has ordered me to give you. Because when he comes and finds you looking worse, looking bad, more than other people, he will have my head. And I love what Daniel did. He told him, put us to test for 10 days. Put us to test for 10 days. And the Bible says, then Daniel said to the guard, whom the chief official had appointed over Daniel, Hanan, Mishael, and Azariah, please test your servant for 10 days. Give us nothing but vegetables to eat and water to drink. Then compare our appearance with the young men who eat the royal food, and treat your servant in accordance to what you see. So he agreed to this and tested them for 10 days. So this Daniel told the official that he's not going to eat what he's giving the others. And he asked for water. He asked even for vegetables, that they can continue eating from them. But there is one thing I want you to know. He asked for water. He asked for the vegetables, but he continued to add the word of God in it. And the Bible says he agreed. And after those 10 days, at the end of the 10 days, they looked healthier and better nourished than any of the young men who ate the royal food. So the guard took away their choice food and the wine they were to drink and gave them vegetables instead. So when they were put to test, they looked better than what the others looked. And the Bible says they were more healthier. They were better nourished than any other young man. And so the official took away the choice food, took away the wine, and gave them vegetables instead. And I want you to see the type of sacrifice that Daniel did. And after that sacrifice, I want you to see what happened to him. Are Kanyeki, you're welcome. Lillian Kasioka, you're welcome. Kadeni Kulohoma, you're welcome. Nice to see you, even as we read the word of God. Now, we are talking about the mark of distinction. The Lord distincting you, that which you should do to retain the mark of distinction, that we do not conform to the world, that we do not conform to the patterns of this world. And even as the Lord distinct us, what is causing other people to cry will not cause us to cry, because we are holding on to our God. And the Bible says in verse 14, to these four young men, God gave them knowledge, understanding of all kinds of literature and learning, and Daniel could understand vision and dreams of all kinds. So after they sacrificed, after they refused to eat the choice fruit from the king, after they kept away the wine and were doing the vegetables and water, the Bible says, and God gave them knowledge, understanding of all kind of literature and learning. So this official was refusing to agree to their plea so that they do not look worse. But the Bible is saying, instead of looking worse, they looked better. And instead of performing less in class, they performed better. We all know about nutrition. We all know that we need a balanced diet. We all know that we need to eat healthy so that we can remain healthy. I hear a young man who wants to eat vegetables and drink water only for the next 3 years. And yet, instead of growing worse, they are growing better. And instead of performing, failing to perform, they perform better. We are always told to give the children omega, see omega 3, omega what, so that they can perform better in school. And these people did not have anyone to give them the omega 3, but the God they trusted in was able to supply. And this is my point. May our God distinguish you in both wisdom. May our God distinguish you in understanding, and even in your looks, in your appearance, that even those that are your age mates, your peers, will know that you carry a God. They will know that you have a mark. You are much higher, much ahead because of the God you carry. At the end of the time set by the king, the Bible says in verse 18, at the end of the time set by the king to bring them in, the chief official presented them to Nebuchadnezzar. The king talked with them, and he found none equal. I want you to underline verse 19. The king talked with them, and he found none equal to Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. So they entered the king's service. So these people had been chosen with the same credentials, with the same qualifications. They were all from loyal families. They were all standing upright, handsome. They all had intellect. The Bible says they had aptitude of every kind of learning. But at the end of the training, the Bible says Nebuchadnezzar found none equal to these four people that refused to defile themselves. I want to challenge you. What are you doing to conform? What are you doing to follow in line together with what is understandable in this generation and in this era? What is it that you're doing, that you're conforming to the patterns of the world? And the Bible says in Romans 12, do not be conformed, but ye be transformed by the renewal of your mind. These are people who said they will, risk their lives, refuse to eat the choice food from the king. They refused pleasure. And the Bible says there was not found any like them. Verse 19, the king talked with them, and he found none equal to Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. So they entered the king's service. In every matter of wisdom and understanding about which the king questioned them, he found them 10 times better than the magicians and the enchanters in his whole kingdom. I wish I can shout that. The Bible says, in every matter of wisdom and understanding about which the king questioned them, he found them 10 times better than the magicians and the enchanters in the whole kingdom. And Daniel remained there until the first year of King Cyrus. Praise the Lord. So they stood. They were standing, they were distinguished, they were, that top, the cream of the whole kingdom. And mind you, all these were from Israel. All these were not the natives of Babylon. And yet, because of their God, none was found equal to them. And even as we prepare for Thursday, I want to pray for you for a mark of distinction, for grace to stand, that the Lord will distinct you from the other people around you. If you are a pastor, that he will distinguish you from other pastors. if you are employed, he will distinguish you from every other employee, that you will carry a mark of God. And I pray that this heart will get to you, that we do not conform to the patterns of the world. Monica Mudhui, amen, amen. And I pray together with you that you'll be able to strong and make strong decision. You know, and Christ influences our decision. God influences us as we make them. And this is my prayer, that you carry the mark of distinction. This is my prayer, that other people will come to you and ask for your God, and ask for what you have done to become what you are, and ask you for advice, that they will want your God because of the mark that you're going to carry. Even as we prepare to pray on Thursday, I pray that you pray about this, that even on Thursday we join hands together and ask God to distinguish us. But it is coming with a sacrifice, refusing to conform, refusing to be silenced, refusing to be ashamed, to be called with your God. Being in Babylon, and they are the children of Israel who are slaves, they would have felt it, that it is not right to hold on to this God because he had not delivered them against the Babylonians. They had a reason to be shy. They had a reason not to hold on to God, but they did not regard all those reasons, but they went on holding to God, holding to the standard they had been taught, and fearing their God, and praying above the vegetables. They ate the word of God. And I don't know which you are fearing. You're fearing to set out in faith because it does not make sense. Eating vegetable when everybody else is eating the best food does not make sense to a human being. You know, eating vegetables alone and water, even nutritionally, it does not make sense. But I want to thank God that he empowered those vegetables and gave them what the other food could not give the other people. They are the four of them that refused to defile themselves. And those four were the ones that were more prominent in that kingdom. It is taking our decision, our stand in God. Do not put your Bible down. Do not put your Bible down. And I wish I can say it in Swahili. Usieke Biblia chini. Usieke Yesu chini. Usiweke maombi chini. If you want to continue being distinct, being different, because it is God that is going to mark us. Amen, Monica Mudhui. Amen, amen. A mark of distinction that God is going to give us. I want us to pray. And even as I pray to end, I pray that this sermon will not end here. You're going to reread it again. Daniel chapter 1. You read the whole of it. Purpose in your heart. I don't know what you have been shy of doing. What have you been shy from for the Lord? And I pray that God will grace you today. Will grace you today and tomorrow and the days from here, that you will carry the mark of distinction. And the Bible says they entered the king's service. They entered the king's service. That means they entered positions of power. So I don't know why you're fearing to let people know you're born again. It is only this God that will make you enter the king's service. And when they were in the king's service, they became prominent. They became men to be feared. Cecilia, Cecilia, always nice to see you. You're welcome, you're welcome. Let us pray, and God is going to bless you. And I pray as you read Daniel 1, we'll meet next on Thursday and pray that we carry this mark, and pray that we be distinguished, and pray that our star will not be put off, will not eita zimoa, that we continue to shine for the kingdom and for God. Father, in Jesus' name, even as we have heard your word, I pray, King of all glory, that you're going to help us to make those decisions that will please you, my God. Those decisions, Lord, of defending your word. Those decisions, Lord, of standing upright. Those decisions, Lord, of doing your will. Those decisions, Lord, of following you, reading the word, praying, oh God, holding love, Christianity, and loving you, God, like never before. Even when in the situation that calls us for compromise, that will not compromise because we know and fear you. And I pray for grace to stand up like Daniel stood up and said that he's not going to defile himself, that Jehovah, King of all glory, those listening to me today will make that right decision, that will distinct them, Lord, that they will carry the mark of Christ, they will carry the mark of God. And Jehovah Jireh, you cause them to enter the King's service. In Jesus' name I pray. So God bless you so much. I pray that you've gotten the word and God will bless you. So even as you read Daniel 1, let us prepare to meet on Thursday, and God do you good. Invite somebody next time so that we can be blessed, all of us.